One strength of Unix-like systems is the uniform handling of devices. By providing a standard interface regardless of the underlying hardware protocols, this allows the same program to run attached to a wide range of devices. Notably, you can attach the Getty program to open a session as easily through a virtual terminal, through a wired serial port, or through some radio link. Speaking of radio communication, today we'll use or abuse the Bluetooth interface to allow wireless login to a Linux system. Before we start, a word of warning. I usually try to show you robust, secure, and up-to-date solutions. But what we'll see in this video is more suitable for your hacking sessions than for production use. The reason is we will use tools deprecated in the most recent version of Bluesy, the standard Bluetooth stack for Linux. Unfortunately, if the developers deprecated those tools, they did not provide any direct replacement. So, as far as I know, we have to live in that gray area for now. Anyway, the theory of operations is relatively simple. Using Bluesy, we will create a Bluetooth endpoint on the target system. Then, we will create a virtual serial port on top of that connection using the RFCOM tool also provided as part of the Bluesy project. Once that's done, we will attach the Getty program to that virtual serial port to accept logins. On the client side, we will use a similar procedure, but attaching this time a terminal emulator to the serial port, so we can open a new session through that link. For the purpose of the demonstration, my remote system will be a Raspberry Pi running a minimal Raspbian system, installed as described in a previous video. But this should work with any Linux system. I also removed the SSH server to make it clear we will log into the device without ever using the IP network. Raspbian is using systemd and already contains a service to launch the Bluetooth daemon at startup. However, the default configuration does not perfectly suit my needs, so we will make small adjustments. First, to allow incoming connections, we need to enable patch and inquiry scan so the Bluetooth device will become visible. Strictly speaking, you also need to register the serial port profile with the Bluetooth device. For that, I use the SDP tool, which is deprecated and will work only if the Bluetooth daemon is running in the compatibility mode. That being said, those later steps are only required to advertise the purpose of a new Bluetooth endpoint, and they are not mandatory when using Bluesy on the client the way I will show you. In all cases, if you restart the Bluetooth daemon, the client should now see the target system. Let's now attach a service behind the Bluetooth link. The Bluesy project used to provide the RFCOM tool to associate a virtual character device to a Bluetooth channel. The tool is still provided, but it is deprecated too. However, since we lack replacement, we have no other real choice than using it. With the syntax, RFCOM will create a new device named RFCOM0 in the dev folder, forward to that device all the traffic from the channel 22 of the first HDI controller, and finally RFCOM will listen for incoming connections and will start the Getty program when a client arrives. Client side, we will use the same tool, but with a slightly different syntax. Here, RFCOM will create a new RFCOM 0 device and associate it with the remote Bluetooth endpoint. But the actual connection will only be established once an application tries to open the RFCOM device. Let's attach a terminal emulator to the virtual serial port to check that. You may notice a small delay here, and if you look at the Bluetooth hardware indicator, you may see it blinks rapidly while the controller is establishing the connection. Once done, I can log into the remote system. So, it works. But it was somewhat annoying. We had to manually start the RFCOM tool on the server. So, we will automate that part. The idea would be to create a new service on the target system. Of course, we can manually start that service. But most important, we can also enable the service so it will start automatically at startup. Let's now reboot the board to see if it works. Okay, the board has now rebooted. Let's try to reconnect to the server. And as you can see, it works just like before. And from the board, I can see the Bluetooth daemon and the RFCOM tool running in the background. As I said it at the start of this video, this is probably not something you will use in production, but it opens the door for fun experiments, and I hope you will have the same pleasure trying that than me while preparing this video. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.